Very good morning, dear children. Let us start our today's class with a prayer. God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Amen. Dear children, for today's class, we are going to see the second part of the second lesson, motion. It is a very important section, equations of motion. Newton studied the motion of an object and gave a set of three equations, which is very important. These equations relate displacement, velocity, acceleration, and time of an object under motion. An object in motion with initial velocity u. So, how will you represent initial velocity? U. Final velocity v. So, v is the notation for final velocity. Time t. Due to acceleration a. Reaches a distance s. Three equations can be written. First of all, you memorize this thing. Initial velocity u, final velocity v, time t, acceleration a, distance traveled s. Is it clear? Then, these are the three set of equation of motion. V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Now, we are going to derive these equations of motion using graphical method. There are two methods to prove these equations. One is graphical method, another one is derivative method. Derivative method you will be learning in your higher studies in 11th standard if you take science group. But here in your 9th standard, you are going to prove these equations of motion using graphical methods. Let's see how. See figure 2.8. This 2.8 shows the change in velocity with time for an uniform acceleration, uniformly accelerated object. The object starts from the point D in the graph with velocity u. Its velocity keeps increasing, and after time t, it reaches the point P on the graph. Let me explain in another way. Wait. I have told you in the previous video that you should take time, which is a variable, independent variable in x-axis. So time in x-axis and velocity in y-axis. X-axis time, y-axis velocity. So first, what happened? The object has a initial velocity. For suppose if we are standing and keeps on running, means initially we are at rest, our velocity is zero. But when we consider the moving object and we take time for a moving object, means it will have an initial velocity. Okay, so initial, this point is O. So initial velocity point D. At this point it is D. Okay, at this point it is D. Moves with the initial velocity u. Its velocity keeps on increasing, and after time its velocity keeps on increasing. So I should draw line from here, not from zero. If I start the curve or line from zero, means initially the object is at rest. If I start the curve from zero, means it represents that initially the object is at rest. But in our case, initially the object is having a velocity u. So I cannot start the graph from 0. Instead, I should start from D. So its velocity keeps on increasing and reaches a point B here. So it reaches the point B. Okay. So what is the initial velocity of the object? It is u. Okay, so initial velocity of the object u will be equal to this od. Od. Okay, I need to complete this graph. How can I complete this graph? Let me show. So at point B, it stops its motion. So what is the time taken? That is OE is the time taken. OE is the time taken. So I should draw another dashed line from D which strikes on the straight line at point A. Okay, it will result in a trapezium. Okay, so this is the time taken. So I also have to draw a dashed line from B to Y axis. It will cut at that point known as C. It will cut at point known as C. So initial velocity u can be represented as OD. So what is this OD? OD will be equal to this AE, otherwise EA, as in your book. Okay, and the final velocity of the object v is equal to, so this is the final velocity, this will be equal to v. V is equal to OC, that is equal to EB. What you have to do next is, you are moving on to the derivation. We need to, before that we need to see what is t. T is equal to, this is the time taken. This is the time taken, OE. OE will be, this OE will be equal to this point. This point. This is also equal, this is also equal. That is equal to DA. So next we need to see, or we need to prove all the three equations of motion. For that you have to take your book. Along with the book you have to see the points which I am going to show in the video. Okay, then only you can understand. Please see the video along with your textbook. If you don't have book, means you take the book, then you come and continue the video class. Let's see how to prove the first equation of motion, v is equal to u plus ag. By the definition we know that acceleration, see the book, acceleration is equal to change in velocity divided by time. What is the meaning of change in velocity? Final velocity minus initial velocity. So in your graph, what is your final velocity? Where is v, c? That is final velocity, the object reach at the final position, OC, minus OD. So this is your final velocity, this is your final velocity, and this is your initial velocity. Okay, divided by time. What is time? OE is the time. So OC minus OD divided by OE. What is the result? If you subtract OD from OC, OD from OC, you remove this one, what will you get? DC alone you will get. This part alone you will get DC. DC divided by OE. OE is nothing but T. See, this DC will be equal to AB. DC will be equal to AB since both are parallel line. This and this are parallel line. So this both these things will be equal. So DC is equal to AB. That will be equal to AT. How AT? In the previous equation, A and T cross multiply. So from the graph, we conclude EB, this is EB. EB is equal to EA plus AB. EA plus AB. EA is nothing but U. So instead of EA, I am writing U here. And what is AB? See the previous equation, this one. So this is AT. So V is equal to U plus AT. Thus I obtained the first equation. Okay? Thus I obtained the first equation. How can I reach the second equation? From the graph, the distance covered by the object during time t is given by the area of quadrangle DOEB. I told you that the area of the slope gives you the displacement, isn't it? So S is equal to area of the quadrangle DOEB. This DOEB. I repeat, DOEB. So, what is the area of the quadrangle? Area of the rectangle DOEA plus area of the triangle DAB. Let me explain again. So area of the quadrangle is equal to area of the rectangle OAED. Otherwise, DOEA. Area of the triangle ABD. Okay. What is the formula for area of the rectangle? Length into breadth. So AE into OE. A is nothing but U. OE is nothing T. Half into AB. Half into AB means AB is nothing but AT, as mentioned in the previous proof. AT, AB is nothing but AT into DA. What is DA? DA will be equal to this T. Okay, so S is equal to UT plus half AT square. This is the second equation of motion. Okay, next we need to prove the third equation of motion. For that we take S as the area of trapezium. So what is the formula? Half into sum of length of parallel side into distance between parallel sides. So half into parallel sides OD plus BE. OD plus BE into distance OE. Distance OE. Okay. What is OD? OD is U. What is BE? BE is V. OD is U, BE is V. So U plus V into T. Into T you obtain as S is equal to half plus U plus V into T. Okay. Then we have in the first equation of motion as U is equal to, sorry, V is equal to U plus AT. So V minus U is equal to AT. So T is equal to cross multiply V minus U by A. Okay, V minus U by A. So substitute this value in the previous equations T. முன்னாடி இக்குவேஷனில் டி இருக்குல்லையா, டி எடுத்துட்டு வி மைனஸ் யூ பை ஏ அப்படி சப்ஸ்டியூட் பண்ணிங்கன்னா யூ வில் அப்டைன் எஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஹாஃப் இன்ட்டு யூ ப்ளஸ் சாரி வி ப்ளஸ் யூ இன்ட்டு வி மைனஸ் யூ டிவைடட் பை ஏ. திஸ் இஸ் ஃபார்ம்ஸ் லைக் ஏ ப்ளஸ் பி மைனஸ் ஏ ஏ ப்ளஸ் பி இன்ட்டு ஏ மைனஸ் பி விச் வில் ரிசல்ட் இன் ஏ ஸ்கொயர் மைனஸ் பி ஸ்கொயர். சிமிலர்லி வி ஸ்கொயர் மைனஸ் யூ ஸ்கொயர். ஸோ கிராஸ் மல்டிப்ளை தட் ஒன் டூ ஏ எஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 2as is equal to v square minus u square. Wait a minute. So what will you receive? A denominator, 2 denominator. If you cross multiply these two things, 2as is equal to v square minus u square, which will result in v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Okay. Next we need to see about motion of freely falling body. So if a body is falling freely means all these three equations of motion will be changed, because in these equation of motion v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square is equal to u square plus 2as. In these equations of motion a represent acceleration. If a body is moving freely means that acceleration is due to gravity. So instead of a you have to substitute g. Also you consider another point that if a body is moving freely means its initial velocity u is equal to 0. So you have to substitute substitute u is equal to 0 and a is equal to g in all these three equations of motion. If you substitute like that you will get this kind of equation of motion. Okay. So you will get this kind of equations of motion. Is it clear? Also, if you throw the object upward means instead of g you have to substitute minus g. Instead of g you have to substitute minus g. That's all the small variation. If an object is moving circular path means its speed will be equal to circumference divided by time taken. V is equal to circumference. Circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. Time taken for complete rotation is capital T. So V is equal to 2 pi r divided by T. Next, we need to see about centripetal acceleration and centripetal force. A body is said to be accelerated if the velocity of the body changes either in magnitude or in direction. So whether its velocity changes, otherwise its magnitude changes, its direction changes, we can consider that the body is accelerated. The motion of a stone in circular path with constant speed and continuous change of direction is an accelerated motion. In this case, there must be an acceleration acting along the string direction inward, which makes the stone to move circular path. So in that case, special acceleration is there. So it is called a centripetal acceleration. So the formula for centripetal acceleration is A is equal to B square divided by R, and the force, centripetal force, is equal to F is equal to M into A. Here A is equal to B square divided by R. So F is equal to MB square by R. Up to this, I wind up this lesson. I hope you all understand. All the best. God bless you.